morning all. Good morning children. Welcome to DCEB, Suryapet, Khammam district, Bioscience online classes. Myself, P. Prasanna, working as CRP Biological Science in KGPB, Palakkaveedu, Suryapet district. Our chapter is Challenges in Improving Agricultural Production. Challenges in improving agricultural production. And today I'm going to explain you about the topic, that is plant nutrients and soil nutrients. And also let us discuss about what are required nutrients by plants. What are required nutrients by plants? What are soil nutrients? How many types they have categorized? What are micronutrients and macronutrients? Their examples. And absorption of salts by different crops in the form of table. Children, what is a nutrient? What is a nutrient? Nutrient is a substance or an element that is needed to keep a living thing alive and helps to grow. A nutrient is a substance or an element that is needed to keep it alive and helps to grow. This is nutrient. So let us know about what are required nutrients by plants. Children, you know already our body requires some kinds of nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins and minerals. These nutrients give energy and some of them will help to grow, for the growth and development of our body. So like our body, like us, plants also require some kinds of nutrients. What are those? Plants also require some kinds of nutrients. Let us know what are those. So children, do you know about the process of photosynthesis? We have already learned about photosynthesis in 7th standard. So let us know, before going to know about the plant nutrients, let us speak about the photosynthesis process. What happens in photosynthesis, children? What happens? Plants absorb carbon dioxide from air, water from soil. Water, the chemical formula of water is H2O. Water from soil, and in the presence of sunlight, they make their own food. What happens in photosynthesis, children? Plants absorb carbon dioxide from air, water from soil, and in the presence of sunlight, they synthesize their own food. Plants synthesize their own food. This is the process of photosynthesis. See here, when plants are absorbing water from soil, they also absorb some kinds of mineral salts along with water. What are those mineral salts or what are those nutrients? Let us see. So, plant nutrients have categorized into two types mainly. Children, based on the consumption of nutrients by plants or utility of the plant, requirement of the plant, these plant nutrients have mainly categorized into two types. First one, macronutrients. Next, second one is micronutrients. Macronutrients and micronutrients. First, let us know what are macronutrients. You know already about the nutrient. Next, the macro means large. Macro means large quantity. So here, what are macronutrients? The nutrients that required by plants in large quantities are called macronutrients. Children, repeat it again. What are macronutrients? Minerals that are required in large quantities by plants are called macronutrients. Means required in larger quantities by the plants. So let us write that. Say again, children. Minerals that require in large quantities by plants are called what we call, children? Macronutrients. What are the examples for macronutrients? The examples for macronutrients are nitrogen. Next, phosphorus. Next, potassium. Salts. So, examples for minerals, macronutrients, the nutrients or the mineral salts absorbed by the plants. Examples for macronutrients are nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. So chemical symbol of nitrogen is, we indicate with N. What is that? N. Nitrogen, N. Phosphorus with P. And potassium with K. Why K, madam? Why so? K. Because potassium, the chemical name of potassium is kalium. What is that? Kalium. So, based on that chemical name, we indicate potassium chemical symbol as K. Okay? Nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, these three mainly comes under macronutrients. Means these nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium salts are required by plants in large quantities. So that is the reason we call these nutrients as macronutrients. Means macronutrient. Shall we observe it in chart? Have a look here, children. Macronutrients are nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. These three are mainly called as macronutrients. That is the reason I wrote in a big letters. Next, coming to micronutrients. What are micronutrients? Micro means small. Micro means small. You know about the microorganisms we have.
have learned in 8th standard, story of microorganisms. Micro means small, small things, microorganisms, small living things. Okay, micro means small. So let us write, what are micronutrients? Here, minerals that are required in small quantities by plants are called micronutrients. Minerals that are required by plants in small quantities are called, small quantities are called micronutrients. Let us write it. Repeat it, children. What are micronutrients? Minerals that required in small quantities by plants are called micronutrients. Micronutrients means, micro means small now. So plants require some kinds of nutrients or mineral salts in very less amounts or small quantities. So that is the reason we call these nutrients as a micronutrients. So let us see the examples for micronutrients. Iron, manganese, nickel, copper, zinc, many are there, like a boron, then molybdenum, many are there, many micronutrients are there, I have written some of them. First, iron, manganese, nickel, copper, zinc, boron, molybdenum. The chemical symbol for iron is Fe. Means the chemical name of iron is generally ferrous. That is what? Ferrous. So that's the reason we indicate iron as Fe according to periodic table. Okay, ferrous is iron. Next, manganese with Mn. Nickel, Ni. Copper, Cu. Here also, copper, the chemical name of copper is called as cuprous. What is that? Cuprous. So, we indicate copper as Cu. Next, zinc. Zinc can be written as Zn. Boron. Boron is a B. Molybdenum is Mb. Okay, these all are the micronutrients required by the plants in less quantities or small quantities. So let us observe micronutrients in the chart also. Micronutrients, those are iron, manganese, nickel, copper, zinc, chlorine, molybdenum, boron. These all are micronutrients. Children, did you observe one thing? Here I have mentioned plants, right side of the plant I have mentioned macronutrients, left side micronutrients. The macronutrients I have written, the chemical symbol of new macronutrients I have written in a big letters. So large size, so these are required in large quantities. The macronutrients are required in large quantities. That's why I wrote it in big letters. And micronutrients are required in less quantities or small quantities. So I have written it as a with a small letters, right? Small letters. These are macro and micronutrients. So when we grow a crop, plants absorb all these nutrients in required amounts. Plants absorb all these macro and micro nutrients. Here, let us write about the table. It shows the amounts of nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium salts are used by different crops. This table shows the amounts of absorption of these nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium salts by different crops. Let us see in the table. If we see the rice crop, it requires 34% of nitrogen, 22% of phosphorus and 67% of potassium. Then what is the how much is the yielding from rice crop? Means that is 2240 kgs per hectare. Here hectare means 2.45 acres children. 1 hectare is equal to 2.45 acres. So when we grow a rice crop in our field, then it gives the yieldings of 2240 kgs per hectare. So to give this much yielding, rice crop requires these amounts of NPK salts, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium salts. Next, coming to wheat crop. Wheat crop requires 56% of nitrogen, 22% of phosphorus, 67% of potassium. Wheat crop absorbs these amounts of nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium salts to give 1560 kgs per hectare yieldings. To give the yielding of 1560 kgs per hectare. Next, millets. If we grow millets in a field, then millets utilizes 56% of nitrogen, 15% of phosphorus, 146% of potassium by millets. Then per hectare, millets give the yieldings of 1792 kgs per hectare. In the same way, if we grow corn, in case of corn, corn crop use 36% of nitrogen, 20% of phosphorus and 39% of potassium. Then corn crop gives 2016 kgs per hectare of yielding. Next, sugarcane. Sugarcane uses 90% of nitrogen, 17% of phosphorus, 202% of potassium. Then sugarcane crop gives the yielding of 67,200 kgs per hectare. Next, groundnut crop uses 78% nitrogen, 22% phosphorus, 45% potassium, and to give the yielding of 1904 kgs per hectare. Here, these are the crops. They absorb these nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium salts in these amounts as shown in the table. Okay. So here we have learnt about the means what, how much yielding per hectare is it, the crop is giving per hectare, and what are the required salts, absorption of salts by different various crops. Next, when we cultivate any of these crops in a field, they absorb these amount of nutrients as mentioned in the table. Okay children, if you grow rice crop, it utilizes 34, 22, 67. Simply we see what is that NPK. We treat it as a NPK. Nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. Okay. Then, coming to soil nutrients. Let us learn about soil nutrients now. Plants require some kinds of nutrients. They are macronutrients, micronutrients. Their examples and absorption of salts by the different crops. We learned now. So requirement of plants we have seen now. But what is there in the soil? Now we discuss about the soil nutrients. Soil nutrients. Think, children, if a field is cultivated for many years with the same crop, what would happen to the nutrient content of the soil? If a field is cultivating with the same crop for many years, what would happen to the nutrient content of the soil? Then, how does the soil replenish or get back its nutrients? How does the soil get back its nutrients again? Let us know about these soil nutrients in detail. So, what is the first question I asked? If a field is cultivated for many years with the same crop, what happens? What would be the situation? Then, if a field is grown by a crop with the same crop for many years, nutrient content of the soil will be disturbed and decreases. That soil will be in loss of nutrients. The already present nutrients in that soil will be consumed by the crops over year and year, many years, for many years. That nutrient, amounts of nutrients will be decreased if we cultivate the same crop for many years. The nutrient content of the soil will be decreased. So, how does the soil replenish or regain the nutrients in the soil? When the crop is grown in a field, the nutrients will be consumed by the plants. So, then plants replenish that nutrients in many ways. There are many ways for the replacement of these nutrients in the soil. Let us see what are those. First, naturally. In a natural way. And the natural way, by rotating crops, then adding organic manure, then adding by using chemical fertilizer. Okay, children? Okay. So, what we are discussing? If we grow a crop for many years in the same field, say when the same crop is growing in a field for many years, nutrient percent in that soil will be decreased, nutrient content of the soil will be disturbed. So, how does the soil replenish the nutrients again and again? Here, there are many ways. One is natural way. What is that? In the natural way means what happened? That by the death and decay of plants and animals. From the death and decay of plants and animals. Children, you know that wastages of plants and animals, the dead particles of plants and animals will be decomposed by the decomposers, and they converts into organic matter, and it contains that a particular organic matter contains different kinds of required nutrients in the soil. So in the natural way, in the natural way, the death and decay of plants and animals add nutrients to the soil in a natural way. This process occurs too slow. This is the addition of this death and decay of nutrients, particles from the animals and plants. This process occurs too slow, but it is commercially useful. It's a continuous process. Plants and animals, how plants, animals, and after death of animals, these particles will be mixed up with the soil, converts into organic matter, then the nutrients present in their body mixed up with the soil and again utilized by the plants. So this is the natural way. It's continuous process, takes long time and too slow, but it is commercially much useful. If there are another ways also, they are rotating crops. When we cultivate crops, the crops are, one crop is followed by another crop. So one dal family crop, if we grow the rice crop in a field, then this rice crop will be followed by any of the dal family crop. Why it is so? In next class you will learn more in detail about the rotating crops. Then adding organic manure and using chemical fertilizers. So these all are the ways of addition of nutrients to the soil. Actually this one is a natural method. This happens very naturally. Then rotating crops and adding of organic manure using chemical fertilizers, these three are man-made processes. Generally we see farmers are using, nowadays to get more yields, farmers are using some kinds of chemical fertilizers and they are using organic manure generally. But not only this process is the natural way, the death and decay of plants and animals add nutrients in a natural way. These are used, following these all the methods, we add the nutrients in the soil. This is all about the required nutrients by the plants and soil nutrients. Did you all understand, children? Shall we repeat what we have learned today? Yes, we have learned about the what are required nutrients by plant. First, what is a nutrient? What are required nutrients by plants? Okay, what are macronutrients? Then examples. What are micronutrients? Then examples. Okay, and then soil nutrients, absorption of these nutrients or mineral salts by different crops by studying this table. Then about the soil nutrients we have learned. What happens if a field is cultivated with the same crop for many years? What happens? Nutrient content will be disturbed or decreased. Then how does the soil get back its nutrients in these ways? Okay, children, this is all about the plant nutrients and soil nutrients. Then let us evaluate ourselves. Find out what are required nutrients by plants, what are soil nutrients, what are required nutrients by plants, what are soil nutrients. Plant requires some kinds of nutrients, no? How many times they have categorized? What are macronutrients? Give examples. What are micronutrients? Give examples. Then
many years in the same field. Then how does the soil replenish its nutrients in the soil? This is all about plant nutrients and soil nutrients. Children, did you all understand? Okay. Thank you.